Welcome back, folks. You're watching PTN. That is the Pocono Television Network. So happy to have you here. We are at Mountain View in Stroudsburg, PA. This is, believe it or not, the trifecta of alcohol. What does that mean? The trifecta means brewery, distillery, winery, and it's just an all-around awesome place to be. We're here with Randy, the owner. I love talking to Randy because we thought that when we were talking about this segment, we thought that you might like to see how this is really done and talk to one of a guy who really knows distilling, wining, and brewing, right? Knows all of those things. And right behind us, what are we doing, Randy? You're going to be able to explain it way better than me.
Here today, we are spending the day mashing the wort itself. And so in order to make some kind of product that we can ferment off, first you have to make a beer, basically. And so you saw us put grains into a mash tun, then we added hot water. That hot water actually activates the enzymes that convert the starches to sugars. And so we need to do that in order to have the yeast consume the sugar and create alcohol.
So one of the things that we talked about is you have such a passion for this, and you were talking about all the experimentation you do. I think that was really fascinating. You just told me about wines and converting those when they don't work. What do you do with that?
Well, in the past, if we had a wine that that we didn't like the results of it, we'd drag it over to the distillery and we turn it into brandy. And so brandy is just a byproduct of distilling grape juice or wine, basically.
With the whiskey that you're making now, how long does that whole process take?
Basically, we'll have the wort produced in a day. It takes about 5 to 7 days to ferment it off. Then you turn around, and if you're gonna make something like a bourbon style whiskey, you're gonna wanna put it into a wood barrel, a charred wood barrel for approximately 2 years. So that adds handling time and expenses in itself. And so it's usually for a good bourbon style whiskey, you're looking at between 2 to 6 years. Some of our brandies have been in barrel now for 7 years. We don't believe that it's all about time as much as it is about maturity. And so if our whiskey or our brandy starts to mature earlier, it happens to be in a barrel that breathes a lot, it can actually accelerate the whole process. And sometimes we can get one out after 4 or 5 years that has the same quality.
Wow, so you really started as a winery, correct?
We did. We actually started in the basement of our home, and I planted about 70 vines along our split rail fence. And they just took off. They grew like weeds. And so I went up and started cutting some trees down, and we put 250 vines in up on top of the hill, and they did well too. From that point on, we just continued to expand and expand until we ran out of growing room. We pretty much took down every tree we could. And then the couple that owned this 100-acre farm approached us about keeping it green and buying it from them and turn it into a vineyard. I came and looked at it, and it was just a gem. It was just a gorgeous piece of property that hadn't been touched, with some beautiful views. And so we just put it in God's hand and said, well, if we can get a loan for this kind of property, we'll go ahead and do it. So we built this building, and while we were doing it, we decided to do it right. Let's have something for everybody. So we not only went with winemaking equipment, but we went with brewing equipment and distilling equipment. And so we packed a lot into a fairly small spot, but everybody that comes here seems to really enjoy the fact that we have all three beverages for them, and they're basically homegrown. They're homemade right here.
And it's one thing that strikes me is the view is so beautiful, too, and you're right in the middle of the Pocono Mountains. Do you think that having the product, growing it here in the Pocono Mountains, makes a difference with taste and quality?
Yeah, actually, we do believe that, and that's why we keep planting. We're gonna expand until we run out of space here. We've got 12 acres of grapes in production right now, with another 4 over on the other property, and our hope is to get another 25 or 30 acres in before too long.
What's next for Mountain View, do you think?
Well, at this point in time, we feel like we're in a position where we want to expand into some retail outlets. A lot of our guests, their only complaint to us is that they have to drive so far to get to us. And so we're just now in the process of expanding. We've got two locations that are pretty much etched in stone, with another really big location that we haven't signed anything on yet coming within the next year and a half or so. So we're just thinking we're just going to start to spread out, make it easier for people to get our product.
Well, we're happy we made the drive up here, Randy. It's always great to spend time with you. Thanks. Linda, right here in Mountain View. It's a wonderful experience, and it's a wonderful place to visit when you're coming here to the Pocono Mountains. We talk about the things that make the Pocono Mountains unique and great. We're standing right here, right in the midst of it. And as always, I'm so happy that you've joined us. And for Randy and for Mountain View, I'm Chris Barrett. Thanks for watching.